Today I'm going to repair my HP Envy DV4 5220 US model laptop. And my primary issue with it right at this point is the touchpad no longer works. Now, I'll give you some background. It started acting a little flaky and once in a while it would stop working and then start working again and eventually just quit working altogether. So I said, okay, well, it must be a bad touchpad. Let's replace it. So I bought a new touchpad and installed it. This original touchpad I thought was the problem. So in order to replace the touchpad, you got to basically replace the top cover on the laptop. But that did not fix the problem, even though it actually replaced all the hardware that was included with the touchpad. So now at that point, I was like, okay, I know it's not my touchpad. It must be something else. Well, there's only one other thing that all the touchpad connects to. That's the motherboard. I bought a new motherboard. There we go. And thank you, eBay, a used new motherboard anyway. And hopefully it's functioning just fine. They assured me it was when I bought it. But regardless, the next step is to replace the motherboard on this laptop and pray that fixes the mouse functionality. So I really like this laptop. That's why I spent, actually on eBay, I got this motherboard for $45, which was I thought was very fair. So what I'm gonna do first off is take the keyboard off. Actually, I'll show you what's happening right now and how I know it's the touchpad, because when I connect a mouse to it, as you can see here, it's, you know, a wireless mouse is what I have on it, and it functions fine with a USB wireless mouse. And I've tried this in Linux and Windows. I dual booted it with a USB live version of Linux, and it's not a driver issue because the same thing happens in Linux. The touchpad doesn't work there either. So there's no way there's no way it's a software issue. It's actually a hardware issue, and Linux, booting it up with a live USB Linux distribution sort of proves that, because the two operating systems have nothing to do with each other. The driver for Linux should be fine. So now that I know it's a hardware issue and I know it's not the top cover touchpad, the actual physical touchpad, as you can see, nothing going on there. The buttons don't work. And I know it's the only thing left is the motherboard. So I'm going to change the motherboard, show you how to do that and how to disassemble the laptop to the point where you can actually replace the motherboard. So first thing we're gonna do is shut the laptop down. So just gracefully do that. And after we're done doing this, first step will be to take the battery out of the back, remove the power supply or the power cable here, and then we'll go from there. Obviously I got some Windows updates going on here. So once that's done, continue by removing the battery. And then the next step after that will be removing the keyboard. And I'll show you how to do both those things. All right, we've got the laptop powered down successfully. We're gonna pull out the actual power cord there. Actually, I'm gonna shut it down here. All right, so we're gonna flip it over. There we go. And remove the battery, just slide this switch over, like so. Battery comes off, straightforward. And then you do the same thing again to remove the access door or access panel to the actual keyboard. So pull it all the way forward and you see that you go into the orange there and that panel just pulls right off. So next we got two screws to remove and then the keyboard will come right out. So here's the two screws we're gonna have to remove. There's one here and one here. And these two screws release the keyboard from the actual laptop itself. Those are the only two screws you need to take out. And I'll zoom in a little bit here so you can see something else too. And you'll notice that there is a small little keyboard emblem right beside each one of them. So that's basically how you know which ones they are. If you have an issue locating them, but basically it's this one and this one right here. So let's take it, my Phillips number one is what I'm gonna be using. And that's on a precision screwdriver. Hopefully you have one of those. And basically we just unscrew it. There we go. And it may or may not come out. My screwdriver isn't as magnetized as it should be, so it's not pulling out the screws. But once they're loose, They should just fall right out when you tip the laptop over, so we'll do that right now. There they go. Both screws are out now, and they look like that. Very quite tiny. Anyways, regardless, we'll put them aside for now. And so there's the screws out of the laptop. Next thing you're gonna do is flip it over. And now we're gonna remove the keyboard. We've got the screws off the back of the keyboard, so we're ready to remove the keyboard. And I'm just gonna use a stiff piece of paper clip. This is a real stiff paper clip. And I'm gonna use this tool to push through the screw hole and on the back of the keyboard so that I can unsnap it from the front cover, the top cover. If you don't have one of these, maybe a longer screwdriver like that will do, or perhaps a skinny nail that's fairly long, or whatever that's long enough to go through that screw hole and push on the keyboard. So I'll show you how to do that next. So we'll flip it up like this. And the screw hole you wanna use will be the upper left-hand screw nearest the battery up here. Okay, and what we're gonna do is put the paperclip in the center of the hole all the way down, and then we're gonna push against the keyboard. And I'll show you what happens when you do that. Okay, so there we are looking at the keyboard. I'm putting my hand here so when it pops off, it doesn't go flying. So I'm pushing down on that paperclip. Let me see, there we go. And as I push down on the paperclip, you see that it lifts up. Now once it lifts up, you just put your finger on it like so, and then just slide it around and it'll just snap off. Don't worry about that. And at that point, your keyboard will become free as just like that. So next, you have a ribbon cable on the back, as you can see here, and it's fairly flexible. So don't worry too much about it, but don't rip on it. Don't pull on hard. So let's zoom in onto the connector here so I can show you how to take it off and actually how to put it back on too. So there's the connector. And you'll notice a few things. Number one, there's a blue strip on it, and that blue strip faces you. You can actually put this connector upside down and it will fit upside down, but it won't work upside down. So there it is. So next, you see that there's a brown bar here, and that's the actual lock. So we're gonna lift that up. You can use your fingernail. I don't have any right now, so I'll just use the paper clip to lift it. And once you do that, it just pops right off. Okay, so we've got the keyboard off. Next, we're gonna remove every screw on the back of this laptop, except for two, this one and this one. And you can't see those screws because they're under those rubber feet. But the reason we're not removing those two is because they're securing the actual hinges for the LCD panel or display panel. And before we take those off, what we want to do is we want to actually open up the case or open up the clamshell so it's accessible so that we can remove the actual top cover as well. Reason for doing that is that if you take those screws off and open up the clamshell, you're gonna put a lot of stress on the plastics that hold the actual hinges and you might break the plastic. So we'll leave those two for last. I'll show you all the rest that need to come out. We'll start with three that are in the battery bay. And these are M2 by L3, they call them. And nicely, if you look down, I'll zoom in on this. You'll see that each one of them is labeled. So the smaller screws outside of the standard screws, which are the ones I showed you earlier, these jobbies, you can get those in focus for you, there it is. Okay, those are the larger screws and these are what I would call the standard screws. They don't label those. So if the screw hole is not labeled, it takes one of these. If it's labeled with an M2 by L3, it takes the smaller screw. So let's take those three screws out of there. And they're in the battery bay, so we'll start with that. So basically what we're doing is removing every screw on this laptop. To get at the motherboard, that's what you need to do. Now you can put these smaller screws in a separate place if you wish, just to keep it nice and tidy if you wish, but it's up to you. And there's those three screws gone. Now I'm going to move on to this bay cover. And this cover here is for the actual Wi-Fi card. So we're gonna take that screw off. I'm using the Philips number one on this, by the way. And it works really well. And once you unscrew this one, you have to unclip this door just by lifting it like so and removing it. And there you'll see your CMOS battery and your actual Wi-Fi card. We're going to take that out. And in order to take the Wi-Fi card out, you could use just a regular flat screwdriver like I'm going to use, or a paper clip or whatever. It doesn't really matter. What you need to do, and I'll zoom in on this so we get a better view of it. All right, so now we're looking at the Wi-Fi card here. And what you're going to do is going to lift as close to this point in these connectors as possible with the screwdriver, and that just unclips the actual Wi-Fi antennas. So there we go. And note where they're going. Black is going to number one and white is going to number two connector. And I think they are labeled here with these little tabs, these little labels on the actual wire itself. So we'll just move that out of the way, get those out of the way. Mine has two screws in securing the card, so you have to remove the card. So we'll remove the card next. And these are the small M2 by L3s. So just remember that. Once you get the second screw out, then the card just pops up like that. And then just wiggle it out. And there we go, there's the Wi-Fi card removed. And we're gonna keep moving on to the next component, which will be the CD-ROM drive or DVD drive. So let me zoom out here and show you that. Okay, so you see the drive is right here. And the screw that secures that drive is right there. So there's no real marking on that. At least I don't believe so. So I'm just gonna show you where it is right there. It's on the corner of the memory and by the corner of the hard drive. Again, we'll take our number, Phillips number one, remove that screw. Gotta get my magnetized screwdriver. Okay, got my magnetized screwdriver there just to lift out the screw. That's how nice that is. And it is just a standard screw there. They put it aside. Now, once you've removed that screw, all you need to do is grab the little edge of the DVD drive here and just push it in that direction and it'll just slide right on out. So there's the DVD drive out of there. Next thing I'm gonna do, we'll remove the hard drive, which is right here. And I'll show you, I'll zoom in on this a little more. And I'll show you all the components here that you need to deal with. There's a little connector here. So, and it has a pull tab on it. So I'm just gonna pull on that. Now your hard drive may not look like this. I got this from secondhand person, so I don't know. Maybe the hard drive has a different bracket, but that's what mine came with. And it used to have two little locks, one here, one here, but I removed them. So if you have those locks, remove those locks. And at this point, wiggle the cable out of there, like so. Don't pull too super hard, but you know, enough to get it out of the little channel that's here, if it's in there. And now we're just gonna lift up the hard drive. And there it is, removed. So I'll take that off and move it aside. Hard drive's out of there. You'll notice here, there's two more small screws, the M2X or M2 by L3s. So let's take those out. And basically what we're doing is taking every screw off the back of this laptop. There's those two out of there. Next, since I'm going to take the motherboard off of here, I'm going to take the memory off of here. And there's two little latches on each side of the memory. So all you need to do is push the latch this way on that one, you know, basically away from the memory card, and that unlocks it. And once you do that, it pops up like so, and then just slide it out. I've got two here. If you've got one, then just do one. And do the same thing again. Move the latches away from the card till it pops up. Like so, and grab the edges and pull it out. There we go. There's the memory out of there. There's no screws revealed by doing that, so there's no issue there. Next, there's a couple more screws on the DVD drive bay along the edge, as you can see right there. There's two. So we're going to take those two out, and those again are labeled right there as being the smaller ones. So be careful with that, because if you put a long screw in there, you'll actually go right through to the top of the casing, and then you'll hurt your laptop. So there's one here and one here. Take those two off. All right. And those are the more smaller ones that we need to take off this laptop. Next, I'm going to take the last of the screws that are left to take off, and I'll show you where they all are. There's one here, another here, another here, another here, another here, and I believe that's it. So let's take them all out. All right, and that's all the screws in the back of the laptop. These did not pop out for me with my, my magnetic screwdriver. It's pretty weak. So there's two still left here, but I'm gonna pop those two or see if they drop out when I shake the laptop upside down. Well, one of them did. The other one is still a little stuck. There's one. Let's see if I can get that other one out. There we go, second one out. So there's the two under these rubber feet are still there. So I'm just gonna pull the rubber feet off here so you can see them. And you can use your screwdriver just to dig underneath. Now mine's, I've taken it apart before, obviously. There is adhesive here, so it won't come off as easy as it did with me. With mine, you just use your flat edge on your screwdriver and then pry them out and they'll come off. And then you see there's two screws right there. Now those are screws that are securing the actual hinges for the LCD panel. So at this point, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open up the laptop and show you what I mean by that, like so, basically at a 90 degree or so, or a little bit more. And now you remove those actual two back screws, and then be real careful and gentle with the actual lid after that point until you put those screws back in, because they're integral to the strength of the actual hinges. And if you fool around with this cover when these screws are out, you're likely to break the hinges or the mounting surfaces where the hinges go. So I'm just taking those two screws out now. All right, that's it for all the screws on the back of the laptop. Now we have a bunch on the top base or the top cover of the laptop that need to be removed as well as two connectors, one here and one here. That's the power button connector and that's the mouse adapter connector. And also there's another connector here that we're gonna remove, but we'll leave these two connectors alone until we remove the actual cover. Once again, I'll point to all the screws in this actual top base so that you'll know where they all are. All right, here's all the screws. There's one here, one here, one here, one here, one here, another one here, another one here, and another one here. Now there's two here that are those M2x3s. So there's one here that's an M2x3 and one here that's an M2x3. So all the rest are the regular size screws, but these two are the smaller screws. So just keep that in mind. And it is labeled here on the actual metal. So you don't really need to remember where they go, but just keep an eye out for that. So we'll take those two little ones first. All right, that's all the screws off the top. Next, we're going to remove these connectors. This one and this one. So I'm going to zoom in to the mouse connector first. All right, the mouse connector is a locked connector like the keyboard connector, and the power button connector is more or less the same too. So what you're going to do, I'm just going to use my flathead screwdriver here, use whatever you wish, and lift the lock like that. Grab the blue tab on the connector and just pull it off like so. So we'll do the same on the power. Next, there's the power button connector, and it works more or less the same way. Lift up the lock, grab the blue tab with the screwdriver here, or whatever you wish to use, and pull the connector free of the actual lock. There we go. And at this point, we're ready to begin removing the top cover, and I'll show you how to do that next. Oh, I got my little screw here. I failed to get off of there. There we go. All right, so we're gonna remove the top cover. I use my guitar pick for doing that. It's my favorite tool for doing this job. And basically, I just sneak it in somewhere along the edge. And I'll show you what I mean by the edge here. I'll just zoom in on that as well so that you get a good look at what I'm doing here. Okay, so take it and basically work it around the edge, like so. And you'll hear it just popping. Don't go too deep, you don't have to go very deep. In fact, going deep may actually break the locks for you, so let me zoom that out. There we go. And as you can see, it just pops off as you go around. All right, keep going over the other edge and working our way to the back. And at a certain point, you can just lift up on it, I think, and it'll just pop off, let's see. Yeah, like that. So there we go. There's the cover removed, the top cover. Now we're into the motherboard, as you can see here. And there's various connectors that we're gonna need to take off to remove the motherboard, which is next. We've got one here. That's power over here. The LCD panel over here, or the display, and the speakers down here. And from what I can tell, that's all. And this one's the CD, DVD, ROM drive cable. So we'll take those all off. The CD, DVD, ROM cable is just a pull tab. Just pull it up. So let's zoom in on that so you can see it. There it is. So all you need to do to remove that is just pop it off like that, pull, and it'll come off. Going back, you just pop it in and it snaps in. So I'm just moving that out of the way for now. We'll go down here to the speaker. And the speaker, I'm gonna use my little flathead screwdriver that I have. And you see that the connector actually has a couple of ears on it right there. And what we're gonna do is just put it right there like this, try not to scrape the motherboard at all, and basically pull it off. There we go. And don't pull on the wires. You do use the shoulders on that connector right there. And that'll make sure that you don't rip the wires out of the connector. So that's that one. Next, we're gonna go up to the top right-hand side and the power connector, which is right here. And basically, it's got a lip on it, and it does also have very small shoulders here. So we're just gonna sneak it up very slowly by going from corner to corner. Try not to hurt those wires like I am. Just be careful with it and wiggle it out like so. There we go. And at a certain point, you can just pull it out of the motherboard like so. And then lift the wire out of the way. Remember, you need to lift that wire out of the way because there's a screw here that we gotta take off to take the motherboard off. So that's three of the four connectors on the motherboard. Next, we'll go over here to the display or the video display or LCD panel right here. Is another one of those ones with a little pull tab. Just pull on it and then it comes off. So at this point, we need to remove the screws that are holding down the motherboard. I'll show you where they are. Here we go. Zoom in a little bit. And the screws that hold the motherboard down are here, here, and here. So there's three in total. I don't know if you can see this one or not. There it is, right there. And we're gonna remove all three of those, and then we'll remove the actual motherboard. And these are the small screws, the M2x3s or 3x2s, I'm not sure what they're called. And I'll show you something else on these screws. Zoom in on one of them. They actually have these little white triangle pointing to them, so you'll know where these screws go. Don't put a screw in anywhere else other than when these little white triangles are. So I'll show you that this is the middle one. The one near the power cord, right there, also has a little white triangle on it. So that's the way to remember where they go back. Thank you, HP, for doing that. Take that off. And the last one is at the bottom left, right there. And you'll see again, it has a little triangle pointing to it. That's all three. At this point, we can actually begin removing the motherboard. So I'll zoom out on that and show you how to do that. Okay. So where you need to start is on this corner over here. You lift it and go in this direction. So you're going to pry upwards this way and then slide it in this direction off the actual bottom cover. So there it is. You can see it just pops off the corner here. And now just wiggle it slightly towards the right. And at this point, the LCD panel will become much heavier than the rest of it. It'll just want to tip. So be careful with that. Make sure that it doesn't fall over or fall off your desk or anything like that. But at this point, the motherboard is off. But here's the thing. If you're replacing the motherboard does not come with a CPU and a fan. As you can see here, it's missing those components. The fan, let's put it away. All right. And let's go and, yeah, here we go. Here's what it looks like. And as you can see, it's a slightly different motherboard too. It's got this chip on it that the other one did not have, which is probably a bonus because that looks like a graphics card that I don't have on the other motherboard. I wonder what that kind of problems that's going to cause me. But regardless, it's otherwise identical. So I'm going to remove the CPU here, and the cooling fan should come off with it, and place it onto this new motherboard, which for now looks slightly different. But regardless, we'll see how that works. Otherwise, it looks identical as far as my connectors go. Yeah, so there's my power connector. Power button connector, my power connector for DC, and all the rest are basically look the same. Slight difference in the components on the motherboard, which is kind of exciting for me because I'm thinking that is a graphics card. So we'll see how that goes. So we're going to take off the CPU and the fan next because that does not come with the motherboard. So there's the actual CPU and the fan. So let's take off the screws that hold all that stuff down. It looks like there's one here on the fan. Take that one off. There we go. I'm not sure whether, yep, that one does come off. So there's one on the fan over here. This is my first time taking this stuff off. And that is one of those tiny screws, not the normal size screws. And the CPU right here has four screws and they're numbered. And the reason they're numbered is because they should come off in sequence. There's another connector from the fan over here to the motherboard. We'll take that off with my screwdriver. So let me zoom in on that. Okay. There it is right there. And again, we'll use my flathead screwdriver here to jimmy it out. So I'm just using the shoulders, prying from edge to edge. Hopefully you can see that. There we go. Notice that the yellow points to, we know which side the yellow points to, which side the red points to. And that cable is free, or connector and cable is free. And next we're gonna take the screws out of the CPU heatsink. And we'll do it in order. Got number one over here, so we'll start here. Loosen it. Two over here. Three here. Four here. So let me finish undoing those. First I loosen them up and then I take them off. So one, two, you hear that snap, it's no big deal. It's just a screw coming to the end of the thread. 3, and 4. At this point, try not to do that because my screw went flying. Gotta find that. There it is. There we go. All right, there it is. There's my screw that went flying off here. And they're spring loaded, so that's they'll have a tendency to do that. Now I'm just gonna remove the fan. Let me zoom out. And removing the fan is just lifting it off, like so. And you'll see the heat sink there, and it has heat sink compound on it. Now, if you have more heat sink compound, then use it. You'll see there's an excess of heat sink compound on this anyway. You can just smear that back on top of it, and you know, you should be okay. I know a lot of people are gonna give me grief. Oh, replace it, reuse it. If you, like I said, if you have it, if you don't have any CPU heat sink compound, get some. But I mean, there's lots of excess here. I'm just gonna scoop that back onto the top of it and I should be fine. Again, your laptop, do it your way, but that's more than enough heat sink to use it again. So next we're gonna remove that CPU. And the way to do that is to, let me zoom in on it. And you can see how much heat sink compound is on that. There we go. And this little screw here is the lock. So I'm gonna use my flathead screwdriver and twist it counterclockwise. There we go. There we go. And basically it's a 180. And you can see how everything moved in that direction. And at this point, you can just lift that off. So lift that off. That's everything we need off that motherboard. Let's see what it looks like now that we have it apart. Well, on this side, it looks pretty similar. Not exactly the same, but oh well, doesn't really matter. So now we get rid of that motherboard because I suspect the mouse interface on that is the problem. And we're gonna put this motherboard back, and put the first thing we're gonna do is put the CPU in there. And you know, one of the things I forgot to note for you here is that the CPU only goes in one way, and I'll show you how you know which way it goes. There's even on the original here, you'll see that there's a little arrow at the top here, the top left-hand corner. And you'll see that your CPU has a little arrow on the top left-hand corner too. Be real careful with these pins. They bend real easy. So be real gentle with when you're taking it out and when you're putting it back in. And again, orientation matters. It only goes in one way. Here we go. We'll put it in with the arrows matching to each other. There we go. And it pops right down in there. I'm gonna put a little bit of pressure down on it, and then I'm gonna turn the lock 180 clockwise. Making sure I'm pushing down enough. Okay, I believe that's it. Yep. So there's the CPU back in there. Next, we're gonna put the CPU cooling fan off. Now, if you got some compressed air, this is probably a good time to give it a little blast. Be real gentle with compressed air in these fans because these blades are really thin and really fragile. So canned air would probably be just fine, and just give it a blast. Mine is, you know, fairly okay there, just a little dust on it. I'm not really worried about it. So we're gonna put this back on. Now, one thing I didn't show you before, and I'll show you now, and that is, I'll show it on the old motherboard. My old motherboard has this bracket right here with where the screws actually screw into. So if you don't have that on the other motherboard, take it off this motherboard by prying it off. But mine came with it. I'll show you that on the new one. There it is. So beautiful. I'm gonna put the CPU fan back on here, or the heat sink and the CPU fan. Just put it on like I took it off, and put the screws back on in the order that I took them off. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and it's like just a cross pattern. So we'll go with my Phillips 1 here. Notice I go counterclockwise till it clicks, and then I screw in. And I'm only gonna go lightly on the first steps here. Counterclockwise to the clicks, and then go back down in. Just being difficult for me. Not missing anything, okay. There we go. So that's two, we'll go over here to three. Like I said, I'm not too concerned about the heatsink compound. A lot of people are really antsy about that. I know there's lots on the actual heatsink itself, and I know there's lots on the actual CPU, so I'm not really all that worried about it. There we go. Next, we'll hook the fan back to the motherboard. So we know that the yellow went to the outside here, so I'm just gonna put that little connector back on. Very important connector. If that's not on there, you're gonna overheat. Tuck the wires out of the way, make sure they're not crimping on anything. And mine are not. So next, we'll put that one screw we took off the actual fan, which was a very, very tiny screw. And that one was different from all the rest. Let's go back to that spot right now. Actually, no, it wasn't. Yeah, it was a tiny, tiny. That was actually one of the only ones that was totally different from all the rest of them. Very tiny. I think I got the right one here. There it is. So keep an eye on this. That's not where that goes. It needs to be longer than that, so that one is a mystery to me right here. This is one of them too. There we go. So zoom out. There's our motherboard with the CPU plugged into it, the cooling fan, and everything ready to go back into the motherboard. So we'll put that back into the motherboard at this point. Here we go. And putting it back in is the reverse process of taking it out. So basically, go from the right to the left, slide it in over here, and that's where the only place that's gonna be tricky is over here by the cooling fan area. I always found that to be a little tricky there. There we go. Now make sure your connectors, all your connectors, all four of them are free of the motherboard, and they are. And just sneak it in on this side till it's flat. Now there's three screws. I'm gonna use those three screws. They're the tiny ones. And put them back to secure the motherboard down. One. Remember the arrows, the little pointers or triangles pointing to the screws. There we go. Now, we got the four connectors that need to go back on, so let's put those all back on right off the bat. So we'll go with the DVD one first and basically center it up and push down on it. There we go. And if it doesn't go in quite easily, you're just not square with it, get it square and then, you know, use the light pressure to get it put back in. We'll go and use the power next and just slide it in. It's way easier to put it in than it is to take it out, I'll tell you that. So there we go, that's it. Don't force it too hard, you shouldn't have to. And here's the LCD. Again, square it up, push it down. It should be good. And so we've got 1, 2, 3, and 4 is the speaker. So we'll get the speaker cables back in here. I believe these are the speakers anyway. There we go. And just again, try and push on the connector, not the wires. Don't abuse the wires. So there we go, motherboard is in. Next, we're gonna put the top cover back on. So here's my top cover, and it just snaps on. So let's just snap it on here. And after we snap it on, just go all the way around, including on the back here. You hear it click. There we go. So it's all clicked in. At this point, you can put the mouse connector back on and the actual power button connector back on. Let me zoom in on that connector so you can see what's going on there. There, I've got the latch up and this slides underneath it. So I'll show you that. And you see there's two little black lines on the actual connector. They're there to guide you to tell you when you're in all the way. So let me just put it in. I'm sorry, I can't keep my fingers out of the way. There's no other way to do this. There we go. So there we are underneath the connector. The black line's almost right up to the connector. And then we latch it down or lock it down. And you see the black line on the blue here, right up to the lock. So that's what those lines are there for, to help you. Let's go and do that with the power. There's the power connector. Again, same procedure. Lift the latch up. Put the power connector underneath it. Again, there's no way for me to do this. There we go. And it should just slide in underneath here. And then at that point, you see that the first black line is equal with these little white shoulders. So I'm just gonna squeeze it in while I latch it down. And you see that the second black line is covered by the lock. So that's how you know you have it in there correctly. Next, we're gonna put all the screws back in on the top. And that'll be it for the top cover. Make sure you got it all snapped in. And let's put all the screws back in. And you can start with the small ones first, because then you just get those out of the way, which are here and here. So we'll get those down. And all the rest are regular size screws, so we'll just use those next. Okay, one thing to note, you'll see that there's holes here where you think you could put a screw in, but they don't. All the screws on the top cover have a little triangle pointing to where they go. If you don't see a triangle next to the hole, do not put a screw in it. I believe that is all the screws on the top cover. Yes. So next we're going to flip this over and put the screws on. The next screws I'm putting on are on the back hinge. And again, we're gonna flip the laptop over as such and put one in here and then flip it over and put it on the other side. And then at that point, we'll be able to actually close the lid to put all the rest of the screws on the back. There's the one. We'll flip it over. Number two right there. Again, we're putting this one and this one back in first, because that actually secures the top panel, the LCD hinges. And that is crucial that you do first and be very careful with, because that can actually cause damage if you don't handle it right. Okay, there's those two in. And at this point, we can actually shut the lid. Last thing I'm gonna do is put the keyboard in, so don't worry about the keyboard. I'm leaving that for the last. So at this point, we'll close it up. We're safe to do so. And we'll continue putting screws into the back of the casing. 1, 2, 3. Those are the small, tiny ones. Oh, and by the way, you can put the rubber feet now back onto those two screws as well. Once you've got it down nice and snug, just put the rubber feet back on there to cover up those holes. There we go. And to put your rubber feet back on, you're nice to have those. There we go. Push them down, get some firm pressure on that. 1, 2, 3, those are there. Next, I'm going to put the two skinny M2L3s here on the actual LCD bay, the top cover. So we'll go with those first. Remember, those are the small ones. There we go. Two more here, those little skinny ones, the little small ones. These are on the actual hard drive bay there. Like I said, I'm going with the small ones first, just get them out of the way. That way I don't have to worry about them anymore. And next, we're gonna put all the rest of the screws into the back. Actually, two I'm not going to put in are the keyboard ones. They're the last ones that we're going to put in. And next, we're going to put the CD, DVD, ROM drive back in. So it just slides in like so. Screws right there. So we just grab one of those big screws. And we'll begin to put our components back in. Let's start with the hard drive. Straightforward. You see there's a little channel for the cable here. You can wind it through that. So let me zoom in on that so you can see it. Hopefully you can see it, and seeing that it's black right here. So we're gonna put the hard drive into its bay. Fingers are a little too fat for this, I think. Okay, I'm gonna lift up the hard drive. Connect that with my finger. There we go. That's a better way to do that. So fish the connector in, connect it, drop your hard drive in. Being careful with the wire all the time. And there we go. There's that cable back in there. Like I said, try not to cut these wires. Be very gentle. There we go. So there we are. That's in. At this point, we're gonna put the memory in next. So we'll go back here, memory. And there's a little channel on that memory, and it lines up with the channel here. It's a key, keyed. It only goes in one way. So I'm gonna put it in with that to that, like so. Again, remember the angle, about 45, and then lock it down. Do the same thing again with the top one, key. Don't force it. If you're forcing it, you're not doing it right. There's something wrong. Check your fit again and do it again. Okay. And there it is standing up again, about 45. And it's locked down. Last but not least here, we're gonna go with the Wi-Fi card. And this is probably the trickiest little, these little connectors, these antenna connectors are a little tricky to put in there. But, you know, a little bit of perseverance, a little bit of patience, and you get through with it. So, again, this card also has a key on it, and there's a key in the socket. So, it plugs in at the very top here, like so. Now, there's another socket over here. Don't use that. That's not for what this is for. So, this is where your Wi-Fi card goes in, like this. We're going to put the screws in to lock it down. And, again, those are the tiny ones, the M2 by L3s. Mine had two, yours may have one, I'm not sure. Like I said, I bought this secondhand, so somebody else's fingers may have been in here before me. Hence, probably why I'm having the problem with the mouse. But hey, got a good deal on it. And next, we put those little connectors on there, and they're tricky. Don't force them, it doesn't take a lot of strength to get them to lock down. Just make sure that you're on it. And we'll do the same thing with the second one here. Make sure you're over the circle of it, and then just push down on the top. And it'll just give you the slightest little snap when you cut it in right. Okay, so they're in there like that. Let me zoom in on that a little bit more so you can see what I've done there. Okay, and you know, they should be able to move a little bit, but they should be snapped in. They shouldn't pop off too easy. They basically like that is locked down. So I'll zoom out. Now the next thing we're gonna do is put the keyboard back on. Again, we'll just open up the case. Now that it's safe to do so. And the connector's right here. So we're gonna lift up the connector like so. Let me zoom in on that, do that again. Sorry guys. There it is. So lift it up. Orientate your keyboard in the right direction. So let me zoom out. So your keyboard is oriented this way. So flip it this way. Grab your tab. Again, the blue portion of the actual connector faces you. Slide it in. So let me zoom in. Okay. And you'll note that the two little protruding tabs on that go right into the actual connector. There we go. And before you lock it down, see if I can get any zoom, further zoom in, so you can see it there. And the same thing on the bottom. Not sure whether you can see it or not there. So that's in all the way. Lock it down, and the cable's in. At this point, the keyboard didn't show you this when I was taking it out, but there's locking tabs in the front, so you want it to come out this way, okay? So put the locking tabs down, and then just press down till you hear it all snap in there, okay? That's snapped in. Flip the laptop over again. The last two screws will be the keyboard screws. As I showed you before, they have a little icon right next to them, symbol of a keyboard. So we'll put those in. One and two. Next, we're going to put the door for the Wi-Fi card back on right here. And it clicks down and then screws in. And now we're going to put the door that covers the hard drive and the memory. So you start near the bottom like so, and then you basically it's off a little bit to the towards the front, and then slide it forward and it locks in. Next, we're going to put the battery in, and then hopefully if I've done everything right, this laptop will power up. Make sure the battery's in good. Yep. So there's all the components back on. Flip it over and plug the power into it and power it up. And I'll show you that next. All right, here we are back up again. It rebooted a few times. It had some Windows updates to do, but there's my mouse pad, touchpad working again. As you can see, I can turn it on and off. There's a little button on here. Just double click it and then it's on and off. Right mouse button works. Let's go down here to display settings. Left mouse button works. Perfect. And obviously we're working again. Everything's cool. You know, basically it just took the new motherboard without issue. Windows 10 likes it. And you know, I'm happy with the way it worked. So at this point, ready to rock and roll with a new motherboard. I showed you how to take yours out, how to take your motherboard out, how to take your keyboard out, how you take your top cover off. Basically disassemble your laptop, most of the guts, except for the LCD. I may do an LCD video later on, but there you go. That's how you replace your motherboard on a HP Envy DV4. This is the DV4-5220 US model. So I'm very happy with the results of that. And if you want to know where I got the motherboard, I got it on eBay for $45. I'll put a link to the person who sold it to me in the video description. Oh yeah, and one more bonus thing. Remember that extra chip I thought would be a graphics chip on the actual motherboard? It was. It was a GeForce GT630M card. So I have a much better video card than the old built-in Intel card. So there's a big bonus for my $45 motherboard, swap. I think I've actually gained quite a bit from this. And never mind, my mouse still works perfectly here. So beautiful. My touchpad is working. I got a new video card out of the deal. Can't guarantee you're going to have that happen to you, but I will give you the link to where I bought this motherboard for this HP Envy DV4 5220 US model.
That's it for my video. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video and it helped you out in some way, do me a favor, click on the like button right down here. And if you wish to subscribe to my channel, just click on this link up here. And that should subscribe you to the Richard Lloyd channel, or Richard Lloyd USA channel. Okay, again, thank you very much for your time and watching.